Euro 2020 is the best Euros ever in the history of the universe. 14 goals. 14 goals yesterday. Two games. 14 goals. Means most entertaining Euros ever in the history of the universe. Without any doubt. Without any question. What a day of football. What a day of football. I will talk about France versus Switzerland. Switzerland absolutely rocked. And France is absolutely shocked. Shell-shocked. Favorites to win the tournament, favorites coming into the tournament are absolutely shell-shocked and are knocked out of round of 16. Knocked out. Who would have thought? What a major upset. And this is not the first time Switzerland is making upset in the grand stages of the world of sport. It's not the first time. In 2001, 15-seeded tennis prodigy, upcoming rising star, Roger Federer, upsetted first rank defending champion Pete Sampras, upsetted and turned the tennis world upside down. And yesterday, I think Switzerland turned the footballing world upside down by upsetting the defending champion, world champion France, and the favorites to win the tournament, France. Who would have thought? This just shows that miracles do happen. Who would have thought that in the first 45 minutes that France will be completely absent, would not be even in the game, would not even turn up. And even the formation, yesterday Didier Deschamps had played 3-4-3, 3 at the back, full defensive mindset, that also was a total disaster. That one also, who would have thought that such a tactical blunder will happen in such a crucial stage and critical stage. Coward football will happen in the first 45 minutes. Switzerland absolutely deserved it. In the first 45 minutes, they were the better team. And they put France right at the back foot. Then even in the second half, Switzerland started the second half brilliantly. They got a penalty also. But then Ricardo Rodriguez, absolutely pathetic. Golden opportunity, golden chance he missed it. And Switzerland confidence went down. Then France being France, world champion France, team of the decade France, golden generation France, brilliant France. Being France, they showed their world-class abilities. And in 4 minutes, they secured two goals. Benzema, wow. First goal especially, he had no moral rights to get that ball. But sensational, amazing piece of skills he has shown to receive the ball back. He ran forward, then he received the back from the back. He used a trick and then finished it brilliantly. Benzema. Then another one, brilliant header. Just brilliant, easy finish. Then came the sensational. The best player for France yesterday, Paul Pogba. He was scintillating. Just terrific. World class. 4-5 through balls he has given in total match. 4-5, if I can count. 4-5 through balls. None of them Mbappe could convert. None of them. All the through balls went waste. Absolute waste. So after 4-5 through balls went absolutely waste, he thought that if strikers are not scoring, let me pull the trigger. And my God, that was one of the goals of the tournament, that one was. What a goal, what a scintillating finish. After that sensational strike by Paul Pogba, it was 3-1. Finished. Everyone wrote Switzerland off. Commentators also was praising France and saying that's why they are the world champion. That's why they are called the team of the generation. That's why they are the Brazil of 2002. That's why they are the France of 1998, 2000. That's why they are the team of the generation. And then came Granit Xhaka with the through ball, and Seferovic or whatever his name is, I can't pronounce his name properly. He was scintillating yesterday. Two goals he has scored. And another player for Switzerland was mind-blowing. Best defender yesterday on the pitch. Akanji. I want Chelsea to place a bid for this Akanji in Borussia Dortmund. I want this player at Chelsea. If we are going for a centre-back, this player can make the difference for Chelsea. He made the difference for Switzerland yesterday. He was terrific. The way he kept Mbappe in his pockets, really, too good. He didn't even allow him to score also. To keep Mbappe in the pockets is a big achievement. And France have two good forwards. Plenty of forwards. Griezmann is there. Benzema is there. Pogba also strikes. Then Kingsley Coman also came yesterday. So 4-5 forwards are there. Then for one defender, it's not possible. But still, he has kept Switzerland in the game. At least. by reducing the chances and by blocking so many shots and by closing down the angles. He was the best defender. If you would have asked any French defender to be in that Switzerland team and to defend, they would have leaked at least 6-7 goals. They would have leaked. But Switzerland has restricted only 3 goals. That is a big achievement. That is a big achievement. People thought before the match, Switzerland will lose 4-1, 5-1 they will lose. 4-1, 5-1. Would have given them the chance. But miracles to happen, impossible is nothing. That's it. Impossible is nothing. Terrific, terrific. Brilliant performance by Akanji. Brilliant performance by that Zuber. Forward runs he was only making by Switzerland. So Switzerland took inspiration from Roger Federer, the tennis legend. They have taken the inspiration and they have showed up. They have turned up. And they have shown that miracles do happen. For France, 3 things went wrong yesterday. First is Didier Deschamps' tactics. No way you can play 3 men at the back, that too against Switzerland, with a defensive approach. No way. Whoever it is, even if your left back is injured, you should play 2 men at the back for regular formation. You should play with the defensive conservative approach. They were absolutely pathetic for the first 45 minutes. Very bad, very bad. Then second thing that went wrong is Mbappe. He had a really poor tournament. He had a really poor tournament, awful tournament he had. Only in the first match he was kind of lightning. But all were ruled offside. All were ruled offside. And in the second match, third match against Portugal also and against Hungary also, he was substandard. Not up to the mark. He didn't look like scoring. Like he was missing lots and lots of chances. If he wants to become Messi's and Ronaldo's level, then his conversion of chances should be better. No way how we played this tournament, he can be the Ronaldo and Messi. No way. No way. No way he cannot be. And he has to calm down a little bit. He has to calm down his attitude a little bit. I think after yesterday's penalty miss, his attitude and his over-ego went down a little bit. It humbled him a little bit, I think. That's what happened. Second thing. Third and the last thing that costed France the match is that substitutions. What this nonsense? It's 2021 and still that Sissoko is in the France team. That Sissoko. Useless Sissoko, pathetic Sissoko, nonsense Sissoko, nonsense Sissoko, absolutely pathetic. He replaced Griezmann. So France is already playing with 10 men and their left back is injured, no left back. So they're playing with 9 men, absolutely. What pathetic, and none of the substitutions made any impact. 6 substitutions were available in the extra time. With this extra time, 6 substitutions were available. He used only 4. He used only 4. God only knows what's going on in the mind. Substitutions didn't make any impact. Nothing they made. Nothing. Only Kingsley Coman played really well. Only Kingsley Coman's substitution, that first substitution was really good. That was the only impactful substitution. One defensive player, I think Lenglet went out and Kingsley Coman came in. He had a chance. He had a chance in the 93rd stoppage time. He had a great chance. He should have converted it, but hit the post. He is the only one that made impact. But other than that, none of the substitution made any impact. None of the substitution made any sense. And injuries also. So many players are going to the hospitals after the match. So many players. Ousmane Dembele has gone to the hospital. Then they don't have a left back currently. They don't have a left back. Digne has gone to the hospital. Then Lucas Hernandez, God only knows what has happened. He's also gone to the hospital. He's not fully fit. So players are getting injured. And there are so much talent. Okay. France B team, France C team is also very, very talented. Very talented. They have that Manchester City. Mendy is there, left back. Then they have the Real Madrid. Mendy is there. He should have called those 2 players as a replacement. But Didier Deschamps is not calling any replacement. Nothing he's doing. I know. For the team, world-class abilities, the players they have, the potential the France players have, they should have beaten Switzerland. But going forward to the tournament, if they would have played Italy or Spain or played in the finals against Germany maybe, then it would have not been enough. Because they're not playing with the full strength squad. Maybe they could have not pulled it off further into the tournament. So you have to bring in replacements. God only knows why he's not bringing any replacement. So these are the 3 things that costed France dearly. And I hope some of the players' ego reduces after this defeat. Really. They were too overconfident. Some of the players. Too overconfident. They took it very casually. This just shows that even if you are a world-class talented team, if you don't play 90 minutes properly good football, if you take it lethargic and be overconfident, then it might come back and bite you. It might come back and surp you.